Okay, now I'm going to be showing you the most important thing in running, and that is to land softly. There are a number of ways to run softly. The first is you have to make sure that your toe is up as the foot is coming forward, otherwise you're likely to trip. Now, you land on the forward part of your heel, but you reach down and touch the ground while you're suspended in air. Touch softly like that, and then land on the total foot. You land flat because there is more surface on the leg to absorb the landing that way, so it's a lot easier. Now, another thing that I do is I overstride just a little bit and drop back, so I'm not hitting this way against the ground. See? And here's the way it looks. See how smooth that is? Okay. Now, another thing that makes it soft is the reason for taking to the air. There are two reasons for taking to the air, and I can remember one. The reason why you take to the air is because gravity, when it pulls you forward, pulls you down and forward, like that. So you jump to change the direction so that you can land on the foot ahead, like that. That's one of the reasons why you jump, and the other is you lift when you're walking, just like you lift when you're running, and you're falling forward off the lifting foot. So what happens is that you cannot continue on walking at a very fast pace. Your muscles tie up because it knows if you go more off balance, you're going to fall. So what you have to do is give yourself more time in the air to allow yourself to exchange your feet. And what happens is you're walking like this here, and then if you want to go faster, you have to go like that to give yourself more time to exchange your feet. So those are the two reasons why you take to the air. One is to change the downward of vault to an upward vault so that you can go forward. But in all cases, gravity is pulling you forward. Now, the reason why the experts couldn't see that it's gravity that's pulling you forward, they see that you land with the foot ahead of you. So gravity is pulling you back. So they figure you have to be pushing yourself forward against gravity. But that's not the case at all. What happens is when you land, momentum takes you up to the center part over here, and then gravity picks up the speed. When you're ahead, gravity and momentum picks up the speed that you lost. And like I showed you in that diagram that I showed you, there is a short reach to this point and a longer reach behind, and that makes up for two slowdown phases. The two slowdown phases are when you take air time is a slowdown phase, and when you first land in front of your body is another slowdown phase. And the speed up phase makes up for both of them, and that's how you stay at an even pace. But if you want to get up to your pace, everybody does this, and nobody notices that they do it, because it's only a few steps. They drop their feet behind their body, which is behind the center of mass over here. And if you take like 3 or 4 steps forward in running, you'll see that your feet drop behind. Everybody does it that way. It can't be done another way. The feet drop behind to start going forward, and the feet drop in front to start going backwards, and you're just falling. Try that and you'll see. Do what I just did, a few steps forward and a few steps back running. Can you feel it? So you may not be able to see it when somebody's running, but you could feel it, that you're actually dropping your feet behind to go forward and dropping your feet in front to go backwards, right? Okay, so a sprinter drops his feet more to the rear than other people and keeps it up. Okay, hold on for a minute.